So next experiment is experiment number 5. In this experiment, we'll write an assembly language program to perform different arithmetic operations based on the condition. For example, let us say we have a condition x as 0, then the program is going to perform addition of 2 bytes of data. If x is equal to 1, subtraction of 2 bytes of data. X is equal to 2, multiplication of 2 bytes of data. And if x is equal to 3, it's going to be division of 2 bytes of data. So the data will be stored like this. Starting from 40th location in the external memory, first we'll store the condition. In the next two locations, that is in the location 41 and 42, we are going to store the data. Okay, fine. So the program is going to first check the condition. So based on the condition, it's going to perform required arithmetic operation. Okay, so let us see the program execution. So here we have a program. Okay, so first step is always write the save the file as filename.asm, attach the file to the project. Okay, next check for the syntax error. Okay, so once the error is zero, go to the next step, that is debug start session. Okay, now since the data has to be stored in the external location, you have to select the location as the address as x. Okay, x for external memory colon 0x0040. Okay, so the location is in the external memory. Okay, so in the first location we have to store the condition, and in the next two locations we have to store the data. For example, let us check the condition for 0, that is addition of 2 bytes of data. So 0 is the first condition. Next comes the data. So let us say the data is you can take data of your choice. In my case it is 5 and 2. Okay, so once the data is provided, let us check the result of execution of the program for this set of data. Debug go. So as we can observe, in the next immediate location, that is in the 43 location, we see that the result is stored for condition 0, which will perform the addition of 2 bytes of data. Similarly, let us check for other three conditions. Okay, that is, so each time you have to do the build target debug start session. Okay, so the the next condition is, let us say 1, which corresponds to subtraction. So let us say 8 and 2, you can take data of your choice. Okay, so let us see the result of the execution of this program, 8 and 2. Yeah, so now what is the result is, it is 1 for subtraction. So it is performing difference of 2 and 8, that is 2 minus 8, which is equal to FF and FA. Okay, so this is the, there is minus 6, minus 6 2's complement is in binary representation is FA. Okay, so the result is stored in the next two immediate locations. Similarly, let us check for the other condition, build target debug start session. Okay, so let us say next condition is 2, that is for multiplication. Let us say I'll multiply 4 and 6, for example. Okay, so I got my data at 40, 41 and 42. Debug run. So the result is stored in 18. 18 is because the result, whatever obtained from 4, 6 multiplication, it is converted into hexadecimal number and stored as 18H. Okay, so let us check for the last condition, that is, okay, build target debug start session. So our last condition is 3, that is for division. So let us say we divide 9 by 3. Okay, so let us see the result of this execution of this program. Okay, so 9 by 3 is 3. So there is a result stored in the next immediate location. Now what in case if the condition is other than 0, 1, 2 or 3? Let us see the response of the program. Let us say my condition is some 9. Okay, let us see what happens. Okay, debug go. Okay, fine. So what is the point is, only for the condition 0, 1, 2 and 3, the program is going to perform arithmetic operation, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. For any condition other than these four, the program is not going to perform any operation. Okay, so that is the result of execution of the program.